ഹലോ, വെൽക്കം ടു അടുത്ത സെഷൻ ഓഫ് അവർ യാപ്പി ഗൾഫ് ട്രെയിനിങ് ഫോർ അക്കൗണ്ടൻസ്. ടുഡേ ഇൻ ദ ലാസ്റ്റ് വീഡിയോ വി ഹാവ് ഡിസ്കസ്ഡ് യൂസർ പെർമിഷൻസ് ആൻഡ് വി ഹാവ് പ്രോമിസ്ഡ് ദാറ്റ് വി വിൽ കം ബാക്ക് വിത്ത് അനദർ വീഡിയോ ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ഐ മീൻ മോർ ഗ്രാനുലർ കൺട്രോൾ. സോ വി വിൽ ഡിസ്കസ് ദാറ്റ് ടുഡേ. ഇൻ ദിസ് കേസ് യു നോ, ലെറ്റ് മീ ടെൽ യു, ഐ ഹാവ് ബീൻ വർക്കിംഗ് വിത്ത് SAP and Oracle Financial and all. There is, I mean, nowhere you will find a better, very sophisticated granular control than ERP Next. You can manage almost all levels, what a user can do and cannot do, what a user can see or cannot see. It's all over there. We'll just discuss it today, something that's very important. Let's assume we have two salesmen. One Johnny and another one, let's say Shihab. Johnny working for the customers in Dubai, and Shihab working with customers in Riyadh. So you don't want Dubai and Riyadh, I put just for you for understanding, but in the same region also there will be multiple salesmen. So you don't want Johnny to know what Shihab is doing, or you don't want she have to know what Johnny is doing. It's obvious, salesmen, they have competition and all. So this is a scenario that you make control on records. I mean, you have many customers, some in Riyadh, some in Dubai, and one is dealing by Johnny, one is dealing by Shihab. You don't want them to know each other, or in the same region there are multiple. So how you manage them? So I'll come to, there's something here. User permission list. Here you can see I can create one for Johnny and one for Johnny, one for Shihab. Right now I have it here on Johnny. So for Johnny, you know what is his permitted documents and all. But here I'll just make something else for him. This permission list, user permission list on Johnny. There is, you can see something here. Custom, there is, when you are creating it, you can see something. I'll create one for, if you want to understand it thoroughly, I'll just create one. Just deleted it. Action, because I created this for another session, so I'm just coming back here. So I'm adding you here. So for Johnny, this is for Johnny. Johnny, and for Johnny we have certain set of customers for him. Let's say he is managing customer one, he is managing only customer one. So Johnny needs to know only the details of customer one. So I just save it and I'll go back to here. This is here in the screen. I have logged as Johnny to save your time. So it's just so this is sales invoice, and Johnny, when you are listing it, Johnny's, you see, it's only appearing the invoices for customer one. Or this is administrator screen again. I'm saving time for you. customer 2, we defined him for customer 2, and we are just refreshing this sales invoice. So what he will get? He will get only customer 2, obviously. So here, this is the control. So here, this is just one customer we allowed him. So, but actually in the real life, you need multiple customers. So many customers will come in one region, and so many customers will come another region. So here, before going to that, here you see only customer 2 appearing for Johnny. This is logged in as Johnny. Here you can see who logged in. Here it's Johnny, and I am shifting the screen. This is administrator. This is I myself put as an administrator. This is Johnny's screen. This is actually opened in Firefox, and this is opened in my Google Chrome. Because I don't want log off and log on back again to test it. So here you can see only this. And here, when you're creating a permission, you can see something here. Apply to all document types. This means you select one field here, customer, and this advanced control, it will say wherever this customer appears, for example, there are quotations, there are sales orders, there are delivery notes, there are so many things related to customer. So if you made this tick, then wherever it's this customer coming, it will not appear. So that's why this is a sales invoice and only customer 2 is appearing. I show you on the customer list. So if he is on the customer list, this customer selling on the customer list also, it will only appear for his, what we allowed him, customer 2. As we have put it here like this, but instead of putting this apply to all document, we can put change something like this. Here you can say it's applicable only for sales invoice, or applicable for anything else, applicable for only for quotations. In this case, what happens if you put here only sales invoice, both Johnny and Shihab can see their quotations, but they cannot see each other's sales invoice. Sometimes it may help, because quotation maybe they want to share, but you don't want them to know who closed the deal. This kind of things happens in the company. So you can make it according to that. I'm not going into that much. This is apply to all document types. And here I'm coming back to another issue. Here, for this Johnny, you allowed only customer 02. But in real life, it will not be like that. Real life, you have 1,000 customer in Riyadh and 1,000 customer in Dammam. Or in the same region, you have 100 customer for Shihab, another 200 customer for Johnny. So in this case, we need to do something imaginative. I'll go here. For anything you manage, there are groups. Whether you are managing items, whether you are managing users, everything in ERP, you have groups. So I just customer group. You take customer groups. You can have it as a tree, like we had discussed back in chart of accounts. You can have it as a tree. Under Saudi Arabia, you can have multiple cities like Jeddah, Dammam, Riyadh, and under Dubai, you can have it like under UAE, you can have it like Dubai and Abu Dhabi and all. So it's fine. Let's leave it there. So in this journey, for the user management, on the customer management, customer management, you can put each of them, the customer, into a group. Here you can see groups. So what happened here, you can put it like a Riyadh group, then you can save. So once you are going back to our session of, you know, permissions, here user permissions, instead of putting here customer 2, you can put here customer group, and here you can put Riyadh group instead of actual user. So it is like that. So in that case, you will get only here, if you take it here, only Riyadh customer can be accessed by Johnny, because here we put Johnny. Only Riyadh customer can be accessed, here put Johnny. So this is easy. Yeah, I mean, it depends on how you want to manage in your company. You can make multiple groups under groups, like group 3, and assigned for a group of users, like that. I mean, I don't want to make it too complicated. When the situation arises, you can just make it. Otherwise, you can always contact us at, as we always say, you can always contact us at training@yapgulf.com. yapgulf.com. So we can just clear your doubts in this, how to make it. We can take remote on your screen and we can do that. So this is what we do, and you can subscribe this channel, so when we have a live QA, you can join us and you can ask questions. Then this is one part. This is one way of managing things. There are some other things, like certain fields. For example, you have a delivery manager. A delivery manager called something like, I mean, you have a delivery manager. His name is Muhammad. I'll create one. You need to create for him. And then what you need to do, you have customer database. So when you have a customer database, it has a quotation, delivery order and invoice and all. So you made some certain invoice for a customer, and it goes to the delivery team, and you don't want this delivery team to know the amount, the value, his credit details, everything. You just want his addresses. You just want his address where to deliver, because delivery manager, he said delivering. You don't want all the financial details, credit details, chart of account of the customer. So you allow certain things for this particular delivery manager, like this very sophisticated managing thing. I mean, very granular. So you will put it like his address, a customer address. Again, if it's confusing, you can join us our live QA session. We will explain it further. So here, there is level, permission level. So you can put your permission level, let's say 3. For this particular field, for this address field. Address field you put, I mean, it is actually, this is kind of little, not sure it's very complicated for you, but some of our customers told us it need little bit of training. So when we are customizing this, we just put on the address field, we just need to make it permission level of this field 3. Then when we are making permission for some users, I don't have much users in this. So when we are making permissions, roles or something, roles we have discussed yesterday. So when we are making a role for delivery manager, so we can give permission for sales invoice for delivery manager. I didn't save it, or anyone. I'll just put it like this. Delivery man. I didn't save delivery manager. I'm saving delivery manager here, and on the roles and permission manager here on the sales invoice. The delivery manager not appeared here. Maybe I just role permission. Okay, just I'll take something like HR user. I mean any role. When we are creating a role on a sales invoice for a particular role, what happens? You give here a permission level. This means, before we did on each invoice, I mean on invoice form or any other form, we put some particular field, a permission level, anything. This number don't matter. It can be 3, 4, 5, 6, anything. So it just don't matter. So you put a permission level. That permission level you assign for this permission users. So what will happen? Only that. I mean, you can say it read and write. You can put it like only allow them to read it, not to write it. This type of permission, once you give that permission, that user can only see a customer address, not everything else. This is another level of managing, I mean another detailed managing things. And there are other things like I will not go through everything today, but we'll come back with another detailed session, especially for this user management. I know it's not that easy to understand, but you can practice it. And this is, there are things like, I'll say user. On the users permissions, role permissions. These are the types of permissions that you need to practice. One is role permission, we have covered it. User permission, we have covered it. Role permissions for page and I'll just show you that. Permitted document for users, document share. This one, role permission for page and reports. Here you have something like report. One report, let's say general ledger. You have some managers, somebody who are allowed to do journal entries, but you don't want them to see general ledger. So you can make it like only for account manager and auditor. It's like that, it's predefined. But if you want to allow somebody else to see that, somebody like a loan manager to see your general ledger, you can make it here. That is here. Roles and permissions for pages and report. So any pages and reports, you can define who get that, who don't get that. This is for the reporting. User permission, and this are not we have covered. And you please join our Q&A if you still need to get some more understanding of this, or send us an email. Subscribe this channel, so when we are coming back with a live QA, so you can ask questions. You will get an update if you have subscribed this channel. So thank you for joining this session, and please subscribe, so you'll get the next session update.